Some things in life never change. They're as true today as they were in, say, the era of the three-day week. Both now and then, people have gone to extraordinary lengths to secure a fortune.
Oh, hello. What do you want? Bollocks. Sorry, I messed with the wicked.
Everyone wants a future where they don't have to worry about money.
Morning, cop.
How people go about achieving it depends on who they are. Some are prepared to steal from others.
Hello, my darlings. Let's get you hidden.
Some of us will do anything to stay awake and earn that precious overtime. Some of us never had to worry. And some of us rely on luck to see us through. Not that it always works. But whatever we do, we will all keep on hoping for that extra bit of cash or piece of good fortune to come our way. Just like people always hope.
Listen, I'll give you a monkey if you let me go.
Yet.
So if there's a chance to discover some hidden treasure, won't we all take it?
So if you could just be patient, thank you.
One at a time.
Yes, sir, how can I help you?
John and Rob and Ray looked, but they couldn't see. Where, oh, where could Jimmy be? Well, what does it mean?
May I have a look at that?
No, you may not. It's mine.
Anyway, look.
Look, look now, sir, madam, your patience.
Anyone been looking for me?
Mr. Barnes, as I said before, I will call you if anybody asks for you.
Right, well, I'll be in the spa if anyone does want me. Busy this morning.
You can't say that again.
Gino, I need a favour. I need you to keep your eyes open for someone. You won't be able to miss him. He's got this big, ugly, moon-shaped scar on his face.
Ooh, doesn't sound like the sort of person would like to meet you in a dark alley.
Oh, he's an old friend, bit of a joker. He always likes to surprise me.
Oh.
Anyway, I want to surprise him this time, so if you see.
Count on me.
You shouldn't be on your feet so much. And you really should think about getting yourself some flats.
Watch your mouth out! Right, do you have my water?
Sorry, that's all they had. Here, which do you prefer? Disposable or washable?
What are those?
Nipple pads.
Thank you.
Just thought you might need them.
Darren, go away. Right, I'm going to the staff meeting. I'll be back soon.
Anna, why are you carrying on with this? Everyone knows he's not the father. He knows he's not the father. Why don't you just put the poor guy out of his misery?
He didn't look miserable to me. I happen to be quite a catch, thank you very much.
Sorry, I'm late. I had to deal with a complaint about housekeeping. God, don't we all miss Jackie?
Oh, is that the book that everyone's got? Who is Harold Kelly?
Bloody hell. A bit busy out there. Something going on?
I was just about to say that Harold Kelly was a prolific jewel thief, and in 1973 he was arrested right outside the hotel. He's been in prison ever since.
What did he do, nick the crown jewels?
My great-uncle back in Spain was a notorious thief.
What did he steal? A goat?
A goat. 27 goats.
Well, Harold died recently in prison, leaving behind him his autobiography, which he insisted was published posthumously. It hit the shelves today.
Why are they all walking around with a copy of it? It's spooky.
Well, that's what he gets to do to it. You see, just before he was arrested, Harold stole 12 cut emeralds, which he claims he hid somewhere in the hotel. And the book contains clues as to where they're hidden.
Find what's missing from Black Princess Lake, and you'll find the treasure which is yours to take.
Oh, dear. Not exactly Yeats, is it?
It's a hoax.
I mean, you really think there's buried treasure here?
Doesn't matter what I think. The books are flying off the shelves. Hence, all the people out there.
It won't be long before the press hear about this, which is good. Free publicity for the hotel.
No, I want to downplay this as much as possible.
Oh, I disagree. Let's get the world and his wife in here. If they want to know something, they have to be paying guests. Milk the buggers for every penny.
And what about our real guests? They should come first.
Hotel comes first. You're right, Juliet, of course. Guests come first.
Thank you, Sam. Right, that's it, everybody. And let's try not to be too distracted by the treasure. Anna, today's going to be quite full on. You sure we're going to be okay?
Yeah, I've got ages to go.
Not really. What, 8 months?
Yeah, like I said, ages to go.
Well, if it gets too much, just let me know. And don't carry anything heavy. Like books.
Sam's right. All this hoo-ha about hidden gems in the hotel.
Tosh. This Kelly chap did hide the gems here all those years ago. Surely somebody would have found them by now.
No, but imagine if they were still here and you were the one to find them. Oh, how you could spend the money.
Hello. Where are you? Oh, you know, I've picked a day for it.
Oh, Lord, you're standing right next to me. So, the book. What's all the fuss about?
It's not coming, is it?
No, it's okay. It's phantom contraction can happen every now and again. I just need to sit down somewhere quietly for 5 minutes.
Of course. Do you need me to help?
Oh, no, I'll be okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Phew. Ow!
First.
In your brain, Miss Posh Boy.
Suckers.
Oh, it's me.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. I'm going to go and get my own copy.
Well, go on then.
I'm going to.
Mother?
How do you do? I'm Juliet Miller, the general manager. Welcome to Hotel Babylon.
How do you do? Lawrence Evergreen. I very much hope you can help me. I have an important meeting. I need to find somewhere for Mother to stay today.
Your mother?
My mother is Constance Evergreen. I assume you've heard of her.
The actress? I thought she was... Yes, of course I have.
It's a matter of life and death. She must be left on her own. There must be someone with her at all times.
That's not really a service that we provide, Mr. Evergreen.
Double, triple, you name your price.
Mr. Evergreen? Sam Franklin, owner. I think what Miss Miller was trying to say is that while this is a service we don't normally provide, I'm sure we can find something your mother will like.
Yes, that is exactly what I was about to say, and I'm sure that Mr. Franklin would like to make sure that your mother has everything she needs personally.
Mother. Mrs. Evergreen, welcome to Hotel Babylon.
I don't like the look of you. You remind me of Errol Flynn. Bastard. Gave me the clap. Before it was fashionable.
Take this corner.
Evergreen, like the old actress.
This is Constance Evergreen, Anna.
Don't be silly, she's dead. If she were alive, she'd be like really, 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 really old.
You're like an understudy I once had. Screwed my husband, the third. Or was it the fourth? I can't remember. Which was it, Lawrence?
Third one, Mother.
Well, I think I'll leave you in Miss Miller's capable hands. Enjoy your stay, Miss Evergreen.
Not bloody likely.
Sorry, what?
Nothing.
Now, Mother is a little prickly at first, but she's lovely when you get to know her. Whoever you assign to her mustn't let her out of their sight, and they absolutely must not let her near alcohol.
Mr.
Four. Four times the going rate.
We'll make sure that she's supervised at all times.
My, but aren't you the spitting image of Dennis Price?
Am I? Thank you.
We should have made kind hearts and coronets together. Robert Hamer wanted me, of course. But Joan Greenwood was a contemptible whore.
I see.
Still, it meant that we met. Those were the most wonderful years of my life. I never forgot you, Danny.
Tony, could I have a word?
Yes, I can hold.
And then, when you're giving your interview, you can let something slip about the emeralds. You know, accidentally on purpose. Let's see how busy we can make this place.
Ooh, eek. Awkward. Who do I listen to? My boss or my boss's boss?
Do you generally just vocalise every thought?
Oh,
Did I just say that out loud?
Speaking.
Arthur Barnesman, please.
I'm sorry, Mr. Barnes isn't answering. Would you like to leave a message? Hello.
You had time.
Ninth floor.
Sorry, do you have anything for a tip?
It's okay. Have all the tip I need.
Arthur, what are you off to?
Spot a brunch, I think.
Oh. You see the woman in this room?
Who could miss her?
One day, I would light the loaf of a woman like that. For a couple of hours.
Never underestimate the love of a good woman. Best thing in the world. I spent 15 years with the love of my life, my Rita. Passed away recently.
Oh, Arthur, so sorry.
Don't be. You know the old saying, better to have loved and lost than never to have loved at all? It's very true. Wouldn't trade a moment of my time with Rita.
Oh.
Let's split up.
Oi! Come on, out of there. Come on, this is hotel property, out of bounds.
Unfortunately, there is absolutely no evidence to back up the claims that Mr. Kelly made in his autobiography.
So you're saying it's nothing more than a publicity stunt?
Over the last 35 years, this hotel has undergone several periods of major renovation. So if Mr. Kelly did hide the jewels, then I'm afraid they're long gone.
Emily James, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Cut there. Thanks for that, Emily. It'll make the lunchtime news.
Thanks, Dustin. You didn't hear this from me, but the jewels may be more real than I made out.
Thank you.
Why did you never reply to my letters, Denny?
I never got any. I was always moving around a lot, you know. Oh, look at this for timing.
Oh, I was incredible in this. Should have got top billing, of course.
So, have you got everything you need?
Oh, you're always so good to me, Denny.
Yeah. Now, I've got to run a little errand, so I'm going to nip out, but I need you to promise me that you're going to stay here.
Haven't I always done everything you asked, Denny? Remember Brighton? How could you forget?
I've been keeping my eyes open, Arthur, but I haven't seen anything of your friend. You know, the joker with the scarf.
I thought he'd be here by now. I really want it over and done with.
Want what over and done with?
I've said too much. I shouldn't.
No. Please, Arthur. Discretion and Gino Primarola go together like roast beef and Yorkshire pie.
I mentioned my Rita to you earlier. Well, technically speaking, she wasn't my Rita. She was already married to the kind of man you don't divorce.
A Catholic.
A gangster. Gary Poynter.
Oof. Of course I heard of him. The Shy Don, they call him, because he never comes out of his house.
That's right. Hasn't come out in 15 years. Not since the day his wife ran off with her driving instructor.
Ah, you're the driving instructor. But what has that got to do with your friend with the scar?
The man with the scar isn't my friend. He works for Rita's husband. And when he gets here, he'll take me to him.
He's going to take you to him. But he's a dangerous man. He going to?
Rita and I were living in Australia till she passed away. Before I left, I settled all my debts and I was left with a grand total of £28,391 and I'm going to spend every last penny. I don't need money anymore, you see, Gina. I've come home to die.
But Arthur, there's so much to live for.
Not for me. Joke's on him, see, I'm already dying. The big C.
Oh, Arthur. I'm sorry.
They say the last 6 months are the worst. I don't want to live through that, would you?
Okay, thank you. Bye.
Not interrupting anything, am I?
Yes.
can't believe people are falling for this rubbish. I mean, look at this. John and Rob and Ray looked, but they didn't see where, oh, where could Jimmy be? What does that mean?
It's a riddle.
Oh, really?
If I could just work it out. Do you know how hard it is being surrounded by wealth every day and knowing I could spend it so much better than any of these plebs?
Actually, that's quite clever.
What? What is actually quite clever?
Well, it's the Doors. The band? John Densmore, Robbie Krieger, Ray Manzarek, Jimmy Jim Morrison, lead singer, who died.
So he's like a lost door. We're looking for a lost door, Sam. You're a genius.
Yeah, but where is it?
How are we going to find a lost door?
We? I saw the clue.
It's my book. Oh.
You okay?
Oh, yeah. Just a moment of excruciating agony and then it eventually ebbs away.
Can I do anything?
Yeah, actually, could you keep an eye on the desk just till Ben gets back? Thank you very much. Well, I'm busy.
Listen, I need to speak to you and it's very important, so could you meet me down here at 2 o'clock?
Why have you been so mysterious? What do you know about the treasure? You found something out, haven't you?
Just meet me here at 2 o'clock, okay?
Raymond DeVille, 56. Lina de Roberto Salvera, 52. Oh, 240. 204.
Hello?
This floor.
I'm sure it was this floor.
Maybe we should check the other floors just in case.
It was this floor! He was right here, and he was dead!
Is everything okay? False alarm.
A dead body doesn't just get up and walk away. Someone must have been playing a prank on you.
Who would do this?
Maybe.
Sam, what are you doing?
Nothing.
Room service. Employing bloody
perverts.
I'm very sorry. If we could just step into my office.
Thank you. My wife and I are leaving and we're never coming back. Come on, Susan.
Sharon? Where's Emma?
Dealing with a guest.
Emily, what exactly did you tell the press about the treasure? And what did you and Sam talk about earlier?
Gosh, were Sam and I talking?
Listen, Sam can be very persuasive when he wants to be.
I don't know what you mean.
Oh, I think you do.
You're early.
No,
okay, the cafe on the corner. Okay, I'm on my way. Come on, Connie,
we're going for a walk.
Why the bloody hell I don't want to go for a walk? Oh, it's you. Are we eloping, Denny?
What are you up to?
What?
Either you tell me or I'll tell everyone.
Tell
that you found a treasure.
Oh my god,
you found it.
A lost door. There is a lost door in the wine cellar. There was a picture of it right there, all along. This is like serendipity or what? I'm meant to find the emeralds. I just know I am.
God, this is incredible.
It's like my whole life. I've just been leading up to this moment. All the letdowns, all the crappy boyfriends. Cover for me. I've got to go and see if they're really there.
Okay, for half.
What about for love?
What about for half?
5%.
20.
10%, but you can make sure no one comes near the cellar.
Deal.
Sorry, Connie, this won't take a minute. Olivia.
You, Tony? What a thump is this?
Thump?
I choose not to curse. Do you know who the thump I am?
Olivia Nightingale, I hope.
And Olivia Nightingale is not a secret agent.
No, I didn't think you were.
I was under the impression I was performing in the Hotel Babylon, but I have to meet you in a shoe hole. I do not do clandestine. Understand me, hon?
Well, I'm sorry about that. It's a bit of a tricky situation.
You call that an apology? I call that a thump in disgrace. And see this? They use cream from a thumping can. I specifically said no cream from a can. You know what cream does to my voice? You hear that? All gloopy.
That was a horrible noise.
What the thump she mean by that?
No, she didn't mean anything. Connie, this is Olivia. She's a singer.
Singing? I had a poodle once who sang like that when Stanley Holloway sat on him. Lovely man.
Yeah. I'd really like to apologise for that, actually, Olivia.
Is this some sort of thumping joke, you thumping piece of shoe? Well, thump you and thump this old bitty. I'll thump you both up. I'll rip your dimp off and shove it up your ashtray.
No, Olivia, let me explain. Don't do anything hasty. Just wait a moment. Just 1 minute of your... Connie, do you realise what you've just done? Where am I supposed to find a replacement for Olivia now?
Old's a pain in the ass.
What's going on here?
I don't get employed anymore.
What? So the eccentric old lady thing is...
I don't get to do what I love. Act.
So you act all the time? Does your son know?
I'm rather good at staying in character.
Yes, you can say that again.
He has his games, I have mine. He hasn't got a business meeting today. He's got a strumpet in Clerkenwell, he sees. Are you going to tell me why Olivia is so important?
Can you keep a secret?
I can try.
I'm busy.
Oh, another one.
I swear on my eyes, he was in there.
You may want to swear on something that actually works.
I think we should call the police.
Are you insane?
In case it's not a prank.
This is no prank, I keep telling you. I touched him. He was cold.
But he grabbed you.
That was the killer's hand.
Right, so we're looking for a dead man with a scar on his face and two left hands. Yeah, Sam, why don't you give the police ring and tell them that? Ms. Evergreen, that isn't your suite. Where's Tony?
I didn't like my suite. It smelt of Oliver Reed. Glorious bastard.
Right, well, let's hope this one smells a bit better. Maybe, George Clooney.
I wish. Ridiculous.
I'm telling you, I'm cursed. Dead rise around me.
What?
Haven't you heard? Today, I find not one, but two dead men, and both vanish.
What do you mean, dead men?
It was horrible, especially the second one. I never forget his face. Shot between the eyes and that scar.
Scar? Where?
Like this.
Oh, my God.
Jeez.
There you are.
Oh, just started my break. Do you want to play?
No, put that down.
Oh, please, I know I'm starving.
It's an emergency.
Is it?
Right. Could you just knock this wall down for me?
What? I don't mean that's not something I should
do. Trust me, it's important.
Look, I may not have the best job in the world, but I need it.
For goodness sake,
Darren! No, I'm not going to go around knocking walls.
Hello, Gino. What can I do for you?
Arthur, I need to talk to you. Two men have been killed in the hotel. One of them had a scar on his face. A crescent-shaped scar.
Bloody hell.
That's what I thought. Very strange. But then I stopped to think and look at the big picture. I have read a lot of detective novels, Arthur. Especially Sherlock Holmes. And he said, when you have eliminated the impossible, my dear Watson, whatever remains, however improbable, must be the truth. So I think who remains that is still involved, and it is you.
So that means I killed them.
No, that's insane. You are driving, Instructor. No. It means you must have a guardian angel.
Who?
That I do not know.
Who will be looking out for me? Oh, Gino, I had it all planned. I don't want to die in pain slowly. You better go. I don't want you implicated.
Implicated in what?
I didn't want it to be like this. But like I said, it has to end now. I just have to do it myself.
Would you get that?
I just want it over with. I want to be with my Rita.
Yeah, but Arthur, this is not the way.
What choice have I got? I've got a bloody guardian angel I don't want. Bye, Gino. Thanks for everything.
Maybe Rita is your guardian angel. Maybe she doesn't want you to die yet.
Are you saying that the woman I love is protecting me from beyond the grave?
Stranger things have happened, Arthur. Give me the gun.
I am such an idiot. Get rid of it. Gina.
Caramba.
Finished. Oh, about time.
You want me to go first?
Darren, don't be so sexist. Yeah, actually, do you mind? Missing from Black Princess Lake. The treasures are there
which are yours to take.
What does that mean?
I have no idea, but we've just got to start looking.
What do you think about Jasper?
Who?
If it's a boy. Or Matilda, if it's a girl. See, those old-fashioned names are coming back, aren't they?
Darren, less chatter, more looking.
So I've always wanted a big family. Haven't you? Five or six.
What are you talking about?
Well, I just assumed. Well, now that we've moved things on. Well, you know, that we'd one day have, you know, sex.
Oh, Darren, no, I don't want to talk about that.
It's just... You're on your own.
Yes, Darren. Yes, I am on my own. And this is not how I thought this was going to be. I thought I was going to get to enjoy having a baby. I thought I was going to get to go shopping and buy lots of lovely little clothes and decorate a nursery in my gorgeous house in Hampstead with my husband, who loves me. But I am not.
All right. We'll see how it goes then.
Yeah. Olivia's just called, actually. Yeah. She's on her way. She's just stuck in traffic. So, let's wait here. Hi, Olivia, it's Tony Casemore. I'm very sorry about what's happened. But I really do need you here today, sir.
To test my theory. The emeralds could be sitting in that very room as we speak.
As we peek?
Oh, yes, very funny. Get it all out. Oh, marvellous. Now I get to enjoy the creme of the Primarola wit. Come on then, Gino, do your worst.
Everyone all right?
What's wrong with you?
Have you found the jewels?
Yeah, like I still be here with you losers.
But James thinks he's worked out the door clue.
What door clue?
Wine. I mean wine clue.
You know something, don't you?
What? No. Me? God, of course not.
Where's Anna? Hello, sir. Welcome to Hotel Babylon.
Arthur Barnes. I want to see him.
I'll try his room for you. What name should I give?
Mr. Duck.
He doesn't appear to be there. Would you like to leave a message?
Oh, wait.
What is this place?
It's down here.
I've never seen it before.
Well, a fat lot of good you were.
Oh, I'm sorry, they forced it out of me.
Well, the deal is off.
A secret room.
It's mine! I found it! And I lay claim to it.
It's not the moon, Anna.
Oi, what are you lot doing down here?
Anna has figured out the first clue.
Oh, she has, has she?
I thought you weren't interested.
Well, that's when it wasn't real. Anyway, what about you? You've got more than enough money.
Yeah, but I like the fun of it all. It's all about the chase, Sam.
Oh, my God. You found it?
Chateau Lafitte 66. I've died and gone to heaven.
Oh. James.
Got
I had been looking for her.
I called her and thumping well apologised and thumping well begged her. Your friend's on the terrace, by the way. I've got to finish the flowers. Danny, we're not in Brighton now.
Okay, so now we've got just one thing missing.
Checking downstairs from now. Just don't panic. All right.
No,
Right, we need to be smarter about this. Solve the clue. So, Darren, you said something about a black princess lake, right?
Yeah.
So, a lake named after a black princess?
Maybe the words are separate. A lake named after a princess. Diana. Black Diana. Diana Ross!
What, Diana Ross has the emeralds?
No, Gino, but Emily...
What's missing? Black princess. Swan. Black swan. Swan princess. Swan lake.
Yeah.
What's this place? We stock into Anna.
So, black.
I've got something to show you. Leave them
missing.
You
know missing.
Missing.
Oh, it's passing. Black. Oh, it says missing. Oh, my water's just broke. Oh, please tell me I missed my shoes.
Oh, okay. Someone call an ambulance.
We need to get you out of here immediately.
No, you go. You go. I want to stay here. In fact, all of you go. I just need a couple of minutes here alone.
Anna. We are not leaving you alone. We are here for you.
You really don't have to be. Oh, Mr. Duck, there's Arthur Barnes.
Arthur Barnes!
I'm Gary Poynter. You stole my wife. Turn round and face me, Arthur. You're not Arthur Barnes. Who the bloody hell are you?
I'm a messenger, Mr. Poynter.
You what?
Okay.
Who sent you?
One of your many rivals. Does it matter which?
Why the charade?
You wouldn't leave your house. I couldn't get in. I needed to find something that would bring you to me.
What about my boys? You killed them.
Amateurs.
I know who you are. Your reputation precedes you. Mallory.
Goodbye, Mr. Poynter.
Get security and call the police.
Okay.
No.
Be sensible, Anna. You cannot have your baby down here.
It's fine. I like it down here. It's nice.
We need to get you upstairs. I'll carry you. Or not.
Look, can you all just leave me alone? I just need a little bit of time just to get my head around all of this.
Oh, for God's sake, Anna. There's nothing to get your head around. You're having a baby. You're not the first and you certainly won't be the last.
Spoken like a true man. Why don't you just get a club and beat her over the head?
Oh, God.
Anna?
Since when did Hotel Babylon turn into a maternity ward?
Johnny?
Hi, gorgeous. No. Something just... a little bit different about you. You have your haircut. There goes the icebreaker.
What are you doing here?
Tony called me. He told me about everything.
You traitor! I told you about Charlie in confidence. Look, just go away. I don't want you here.
Anna, when you told me this...
Shut up! In what world did you two think that my giving birth would be the perfect time for a reunion?
Okay, how does everyone feel about lifting a very angry woman in labour?
Nobody is going to touch me!
Anna, shut it. Who are you?
Me? No, nobody.
Well, give us a hand.
Come on. All right, we need to lift her, but we have to find a safe way of doing it.
Perfect.
Just get it to the left.
Where the hell have you lot been?
Anna's gone into labour. What's going on here?
We're making a mistake. Arthur is the victim here.
His name's not Arthur. He's a hitman. He was here to kill him, but Juliet hit him with a bottle.
Killed my two boys as well.
Nothing.
Was one skinny pale man and the other...
one with a scar?
Yeah.
Don't you worry about me, Gino. They haven't got anything on me.
Not so sure about that. There was a lobby full of people who saw you try to shoot him.
This gun, self-defense. I'll be out in time for tea.
Not if I give the police the gun to kill those men. You lied to me, Arthur. Never lied to a Salamancan. We hold a grudge like you will not believe.
Gino, you make an enemy of me and you'll regret it.
Von Kuhl.
You okay? I'm bloody not. Where have you been? Oh, God. Don't tell me. Let me guess. You were treasure hunting. What happened to Mr. It's a Big Fat Hoax?
Might not be.
You hear what he said? Two dead men. I told you, but you wouldn't believe me.
Where are you going?
You said Anna was in labour, didn't you?
Charlie, why are you here?
pretty girl.
No one's ever made me feel that I could ever make it. Lord, no one ever gave me anything. All they did was take care.
You're just here because you want to do the right thing for silly old knocked-up Emma.
No, that's not it, that's not it.
You wouldn't even be here if it wasn't for the baby. What if it's not yours? What if I lied to Tony it's actually Ned's? Would you still want me then? Would you still be here?
In a heartbeat. I'm here for you. Is it Ned's?
No, it's bloody not. I didn't believe in sex before marriage. It was weird like that. And in other ways too. He had this weird thing when he ate. This is a...
I love you, Anna. I want to be with you. And with our little baby. I miss you. I miss your smile. I miss you telling me off. You know, life without you really is just...
Shut up and kiss me, you big gorgeous idiot.
Well, I certainly missed that. Listen. Just one more little thing. Will you do me the honour of becoming Mrs. Anna Thorne Wilton Edwards?
Yes. Yes, yes, yes.
Oh. Was the evidence?
I don't know. Who called him?
I thought you called them.
I thought you called them.
I thought he called them.
I thought he called them.
Oh, bollocks, I'll do it myself. Juliet, you've got experience. You have to go in there.
You've delivered a baby.
Juliet spent her gap year working in a clinic in the larvae.
I watched a couple of births. I didn't actually do any deliveries.
Oh, just don't tell Anna that.
Will you shut the up?
Well, you heard the lady. Let's pump out of here.
All this waiting around, drag me off the bend.
What's that?
Ice chips. She might need to cool down.
How do you know what ice chips are for?
This is not my first baby, you know. I'm like Dr. Spock.
So what's that?
She might be hungry.
We haven't met properly. We must be Sam Franklin, Charlie Edwards.
Hell of a day.
What was this in this place?
How did you manage?
I used to drink a lot.
Anything else you need?
Johnny, get the back in here now!
Some lip looks, maybe. See you later.
I can't take any more pacing. I have to do something. Do we know if it's a boy or a girl yet? I thought things hold off.
Such a beautiful name. How did you choose it?
I named her after something very dear to me. My lipstick.
Oh, for God's sake.
The name's perfect. It's a little scarlet rose.
You've all been wonderful.
Thank you.
Evergreen. Productive meeting at last.
Oh, my God, Mother.
Who is that Howard, Lawrence?
Mother, I can explain.
She looked like that Hepburn woman. Oh, I can smell her on. Cheap perfume and Victory Veeps.
Sense when you see the three of you together. I'll wait outside.
Go.
See ya.
Yeah. Aaron, you'll find someone amazing. Wow, I cannot believe you just had a baby. You look incredible.
I know.
Little early.
I will.
I'll never forget what you taught me. Tits and teeth.
We'll get you a long way. You gave me the happy ending I never thought I could have.
You know where we are if you're near us.
Thank you, my locker. So, where are we going?
New York. Oh, lovely little place.
Charlie?
Hmm?
I don't do little.
Darling, prices are high in New York.
It's okay, I'll treat you. New shoes.
Do you know? Well, the shops are in the totally opposite direction.
Charlie, relationships are about give and take. I just gave you a child. Now take me to Bond Street.
For some of us, there is a happy ending.
That was so romantic.
One day I would like to ride off into the sunset with the woman of my dreams.
The rest of us carry on, hoping one day it will be our turn to find the buried treasure or meet the love of our lives. Until then, I guess we'll all just get on with it. And look after our friends along the way.
Game here today.
Oh, gamblers are my kind of people. We're not afraid to put our balls on the line.
Damien Rushby's my father.
He's one of the biggest hoteliers in Europe, darling.
I'll take Babylon off your hands.
Babylon's not for sale.
Well, the famous author.
Bobby Mack.
Maybe we could swap places for the day. Cheers.
I believe you've been expecting me. I'm Ariana Adams.
She's here!
Please welcome Mr. Bobby Mack.
Do you mind if I kiss you?
All this. Plus Babylon.
And Hotel Babylon is back on BBC HD in 2 weeks' time. Next tonight, the happy couple return in Gavin and Stacey.